strength of
China. For the national anthem of China.
Of mementos at the halfway line. And we look at the third team on the floor, the three officials. You know, Russell from France, Arnaud from Gillot from Cameroon, and Yana Yuna from Turkey. So, as important as the other two teams on the floor in terms of teamwork, has already some great examples of. Top officials in the world. This is the World Champions Championships after all. So here's going to be Russell for the United States. Obviously, with the grinder will sit in. It still looked like a major problem, just a minor thing, and I think it's a good precaution to keep her off the floor. But this lineup, as we saw yesterday, is strong and really talented. Same starting lineup as yesterday.
Yep, same. And to be honest, I'm really excited to see what Diana Taurasi is going to show today. Same like Stuber. Stuber didn't play enough minutes yesterday, as we would probably love to see her. And Ella Deladon, she just had a great game. She played 17 minutes with 19 points. She was shooting 80% from the field, as we can see, 3.67%. She was just everywhere for the minutes. She was such effective. US team runs great, great transition offense. And they're just not rushing their offense. They're picking the perfect suitable positions for each player. And that's why Deladon was so effective yesterday.
This is roster from China. She's 14 and 15 and 19 and 18 years old. Zhu and Zhu were so effective yesterday. Same starting lineup for China. And Xiao Ting was also such an effective player yesterday.
Yeah, and I was a bit surprised at the team, because she's simply a left-handed player and she was such aggressive into her penetration. And I'm pretty sure US is like strong and good quality team enough to know that they will just close their left hand, or I don't know, whatever tactic coach of the US team is going to pick up. We'll see what Charlton can do against this strong lineup of US team.
Well, Xiao Ting has been on the team for a number of years in the Beijing. Shooting forward coach. He's got a great feel, it's a great culture within this lineup. They do have fun playing with each other, and they're out there enjoying themselves. This is game time. This is when they really do have fun, and that's slightly different from some of the short Chinese teams that we've seen in the past, as good as they've been. Bing Chun has seen it all, both as a player and as a coach. It's always a pressured situation being the head coach of the United States of America. The expectation is so high, the talent at your disposal is so great. And yeah, it makes it fun, I'm sure, but the pressure to deliver gold medals is there for the United States. Quality team, they have a good culture. They developed that in a very, very short space of time, obviously, with the end of the WNBA season so recently. This is World Cup time. This team's here for one reason only, and that's to get a gold medal. And these games in the group are getting ready to get into those knockout stages and deliver a gold medal. It's literally a week today.
Yeah, very short tournament, and US team purple shoes. As soon as they step on the court, how professional group they are. They came for just one thing, to win this championship. They even stated it's the hardest tournament for them to play, and they are fully aware of it. So we can only expect the best out of them. On the other side, China, we know they need to learn from yesterday's performance against Latvia when they gave up 22 offensive rebounds. And obviously, if China wouldn't box the players out in today's game, the US team's going to just grab them and run a quick race and have a second chances as well in this game, which will make them even more than just teams.
Welcome back, Santa Cruz de Tenerife. We're inside Santa Cruz de Tenerife gym. China in the white, USA in the red, and China will have the first possession. Mid-range jump shot, they've got to take and make those. It's no good. Girazi comes down with the rebound. She'll look to push. This part of the game is going to be so important for China. This understanding as Tina Charles throws it out of bounds. Stewart went backdoor. China simply got to get back in transition.
They have to stop them, really. Even though US team, even though China will recover defensively, they're still able to create good and effective positions. But that's definitely must be for China to get back to the back of defense.
Ooh. Yiru with a pass and a two on the little curl to the hoop. Good physicality, nice organization defensively. The switch was really effective, but not when Girazi just stops the box and knocks it down.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we will see much better shooting performance from her today than yesterday. She was only shooting 14%. She delivered 6-7 assists in that game, but still, for Diana Taurasi to shoot this low percentage, she won't be happy with that, and she will want to shoot in favor of her reputation in today's game.
Li Neng could get the three to drop. Girazi has it in transition. And find Sue Bird. Charles gets a touch in the post early. There's that little one step. Step back, one-legged. Jumper, nice finish, 4-2 to the United States.
We've seen this move from Tina Charles yesterday. Game quite a couple of times, and it's such effective to create a separation from your defense with that little step back.
Need to go inside, get a touch on the inside, inside out, great rotation, Bird gets a piece, ball still stays with China, 4.6 on the possession. And you've got to think that Li Yuru's got to be more aggressive in the post. She has it one-on-one, make the move, get fouled or score, can't just keep kicking it. So 4.6 on the possession, China got to get it in, there it is. Not much time to put this up. Meng doesn't get it away, and a 24-second violation. Wu Lanmin will not be too perturbed in terms of trying to spend time with the basketball, because I'm sure he's going to try and shorten the game. Girazi, quick first step, stops and fires it. His short defensive rebound is pulled in by Yu Jai Sen. Early touch on the inside. Just has it ripped away by Sue Bird. Congratulated for looking to make a move, but Charles on the end of the break gets rewarded for running the floor. She gets her fourth and United States 6 point. Xiaoting goes inside, it's the reposition. And out to throw the hook. Great offensive work on the glass. Xiaoting again shows that nose for the basketball. Sue Bird still. Xiaoting there went to work on the glass, gets the foul, goes to the line. The team need that type of leadership. She's always there to give it to him.
Absolutely. And to be honest, it's quite brave to go and help from a strong side as Sue Bird did, but she recognized that Lixiero didn't really look for the open kick out of the ball. So great help from Sue Bird, and run a quick break, easy two after that.
Xiaoting makes both. Charles gets it high. Back, well, I think that came, got a slight defection off Li Ming. Razi off the glass and one. Well, you asked the question before the game, how she was going to come out day two of the tournament after, by her standards, not her normal high level, and she's already given you an answer.
Yeah, she does, and she's the type of player with the mentality. She doesn't doubt herself at all. The player of her quality, she knows, okay, I have a bad game. I'm going to just step up, and next game I'm just going to do what I do the best. I'm going to be a leader of this team.
Well, she's going to have to shoot it again because it was a lane violation before she released the ball. She knocks down the extra point. United States leading 9-4. Nice flare. Li Meng trying to create a little space. Doesn't get the drop. Charles gets the rebound. Bird has a chance to run. Has numbers. Stumble. And United States throw it out of bounds. But throw it out of bounds, we're going to be aggressive in transition.
US team had yesterday 15 turnovers against Senegal, and right now they really turned the ball over two times so far within the three minutes and 15 seconds, 16 exactly. Just pretty sure they won't be too happy with this number.
China into the half court. Nino outside again. Yuan moves it on. Baseline screen, Xiao Teng on the drive, creates an angle against the two. Really beautifully. Great break. It's out of, run it straight back out. It's scored against, don't worry about it. Just get it in and run. Team Charles picks up yet another two. Has six personal of the 11 United States points. Yuan. Xiao Teng out top. Moves it on, little curl to the hoop, off the glass. Two. Is going to chase you on screens if you curl and there's no help, then you're going to have those types of opportunities. Okay, going up, right hand off the glass, gets the two.
Yeah, I believe me, that has been really impressive yesterday. She was showing 100% in that game and just proved it. This
Yuan with three is off the glass, and China Chi not get it, but they will retain possession as Tina Charles knocks it out of bounds. Substitutions come from both ways. Fly away, steps in for China. Checks it in for the United States of America. Sun Mingran steps in for China. Gets a early touch in the post, has to back it out, tries to back it out for the two, doesn't get the roll. And Tarazi picks it up. Yang Yingwei getting a screen, they go upstairs for the lob. Chance for China to run, they look long, great pass, easy two off the glass is good.
That's been a great run.
Yingwei gets the two, they run the floor. Give the USA a little bit of transition the other way.
That's a really, really effective offense because you don't want to play 5-on-5 against US team.
Stewart in the post, needs a pass, nice find. Oh, they blow the easy two. They turn it straight back over China. Kelsey Plum has it. Brianna Stewart is fouled as she put the ball on the floor. Did something she didn't do yesterday, which was miss a shot. China and the US make substitution.
But what we've seen yesterday was that Li Jiero was in the foul troubles against the team of Latvia early in the game. So she spent most of the second half on the bench, and now she's on the second floor so far.
Stewart gets the two out of the out of bounds. Halfway through, 4-1. Henzu outside. 2.5 is blocked. Aisha Wilson didn't give her any angle at all to work with. Kelsey Plum in transition pushes. Trying to do a nice job getting back, but there's a battle for it in the block.
Oh,
check my mechanics with the officials here, right in front of the lead official. They were banging around, Paul making the top.
Yeah, you've got to change the position of your feet as well as the player's moving. You can't just stay and hold a player, especially not as Dina Charles.
Charles with a step back two is good.
He's just so good in that step back move.
Dirk Nowitzki, right? But it's not compared to Dirk Nowitzki. Tina Charles has her own image of that shot in her own right. Second trial. It looks like they don't take the shot. They could have done. Nice find on the baseline.
Beautiful. And
excellent move. Xiao Teng, count it.
And again, we've seen this move where the big side cut is so effective. When players start with the dribble, or you anticipate what the player's going to do. Just from big side, quick cut. This was the pass. And this is the cut from the big side. Great move.
Xiao Teng can't make the throw. And remember, their free throws yesterday almost cost them the opening win against Latvia. Just over 50% on the game. They went for the free throw on a number of times. Misha Wilson with a step back two is good.
Step back to what you just said. They missed in yesterday's game 13 free throws just, which is a big, big number, and still managed to win the game against Latvia.
No way. Turns the corner, stops, fires up short two, but hits the back of the ring. Wilson comes down with it. Tarazi in transition, gives it up. Stewart handles it, early entry to the post. Charles in the baseline, drop step two.
Now, you know, I would suggest, yeah, guard Tina Charles from front, but she's so good holding her position that it's very difficult to get even in front of her.
Whistle on the player, Xiao Teng penetrates. It's incredibly hard to do it in transition as well, when she beats people down the floor. Just outworks her opponent. Substitution for Stewart. Replaced by Del Don. Del Don had an almost perfect game yesterday. And Zhu doesn't get the roll. Rebound as Roy pulls it down and runs. Almost turns it over. Turnover this time. They tried hard twice before to turn it over. Third time they succeeded. Change of angle. Aisha Wilson just too physical. Plum with the bounce pass. Charles can't get it to drop. Yuan in transition. Got to hit the second side. Wide open in the corners. Three is gone, is long.
Great quick movement. Ball movement for China.
Lloyd with the lean back two. Defensive rebound is Sun Mengwan. Open for three. From the top is deep. And knocked down. Sun Mengwan with a feet set. No hand in the face. Just nails the three. China within six with 1:40 to go in quarter one. Lloyd floats one in the lane, pushes it up. Wilson's on the glass. She doesn't get it because Anzu comes down with it. Lead pass, beautiful pass, and the foul. And Tina Charles commits it, takes one for the team. And China looking to run whenever they have the opportunity. Charles picks up foul number two. Extended minutes, quarter one for Tina Charles.
And we have to give her credit to China. In terms of the courage they stepped into this game, they play without fear against the US team. They're really using Asbury and trying to run the floor every time they can, and using a little bit, let's say, not fully focusedness of the US moments, because they passing in the moment you think the player is out of game at that, and that's when China gives the ball there, and that's why causing a slight troubles to US team.
Make that. Makes it second. Kelsey Plum has it. Gets it into the half court. And down is the second trial. She'll reverse the basketball. She goes for once and gets inside. Just squares up. Takes the short two. Doesn't get the drop. Trying to have a chance in transition. Good Yang Lai Wei has it. Take the high. Go inside.
Beautiful.
And that's very good offense by China. Get it down, take a look. They get an early pick and roll. They're patient. They wait for Zhu to get position, throw it inside. They trail three. Deladon has it on the wing, puts it into Wilson. Goes to the middle, takes a second step through, and they're going to call the foul. And you've got to give some. I think Han Zhu's a little unfortunate here. She didn't let the 3 foot get beyond her. Not sure how much contact there was on the way up. That's not a lot. Do you have a view on that one? Do you have a view on that foul?
That's like she has 207 centimeters and Asia Wilson 193, and she really had her hands up. I think there's way more contact in the other situations of the game than to call this bad.
Both ways.
Yeah, but call has been made, so definitely it's a decision of officials, and Asia Wilson has been impressive so far in that yesterday's game and today's as well.
Tough move from the perimeter, Han Zhu.
It's a very nice matchup, Asia Wilson now against San Chu.
Link blocking that from mid-range. She's got a great touch. Close it to a three-point game, last 15 seconds of quarter one. Tuck outside, moves it on. Kelsey Plum, feet set for three, is short. Offensive rebound, Tuck, trying to go to work with the left hand, doesn't get the roll, gets her own rebound though, and gets it to drop right at the end of the quarter. Count to two at the end of the quarter. High score, free flowing. USA kicking into gear offensively, 25 first quarter points. Release the ball before the light comes on, so the two counts. Just check. And there's confirmation. The USA have a 25-20 lead at the end of quarter one.
Respectively, Li Yuan at 18. Two-thirds of this team under the age of 24. This team has got a future. So remember, the first time you saw Han Zhu and Li Yuru was at the 2018 World Cup in terms of senior competition at a world level. Deladon would be long. Foul line jump shot. Knocks it down, well, literally for fun.
As we already mentioned, she's been shooting really well the first game of this tournament, and now just hitting her first shot again.
And Zhu picks up the front cut on the foul line. Her and Wilson going at it again, settle for the jump shot, way off. Kelsey Plum looks at her options. Deladon in transition. is fouled as Wang Sai Yu takes one for the team, because they were not in good shape matchup wise. The United States have got pretty much anything they wanted in that transition.
Yeah, and we see that mismatch, let's say, Wadon Wang Sai.
Someone puts it on the floor. Puck doesn't get the drop. A chance for Yang Weiwei to China going again. It's important, can't really dry up against the US because they're going to score. So your offense has to tick in over.
And you have to have a really perfect game in all aspects of that game. So China does
step back for the two. Oh,
again. She did it again. Han Chu had almost double-double yesterday, 8 points, 10 rebounds, and definitely shows that he's not afraid of the US team in today's game. Oh, still. And again, looking, China team looking for the fast break.
Spot up on the floor. Ball gets stuck. Once the ball gets stuck, the USA's defense is pretty much in good shape. Reaching foul on the drive as
foul.
Yang Weiwei penetrated.
Foul and substitution
coming in off the Chinese bench.
Yang
checks in.
Yang
Weijing checks in for China. Headline possession. Zoom in off the glass. Scoop the two.
What simple big side screen can make troubles to US defense.
3-point game. Kelsey Plum looks to reverse. Shu Wilson has it. Turnover. Could bring China within one. Blocks. And they'll get the ball as it came off of Wang Saiyu. Great recovery. Shu Wilson gets back in the play. Great recovery. Plum slows her up, but Wilson from behind. A clean block. And as you can see, it's going to come off of CU. Sue Bird checks in. Tries the foul line jump shot. Catch and release. It's good. Fortunate thing if you're a Diana Taurasi fan is that once she gets going in game, she's pretty nigh impossible to stop.
Yeah, indeed, and you would have to play really team defense on her because she's that top player that one player sometimes can't guard her alone.
Wang Siyu pulls up and takes the tough one, hits nothing. Wilson comes down with it, Bird has it. Stewart in transition. Nice look, tuck, goes for the reverse layup for two.
Beautiful to avoid that block from Han Su. Going reverse layup always works to avoid the block.
Thanks, Sai Jing. And that's a poor pass.
That's a bad angle, let's say. If you want to pass to your big to the low book, you have to adjust the position to create a perfect angle for the pass.
That's the last action for both for Han Su. Checks back in. About 5 centimeters of height. Gain a year and age. Brianna Stewart out top. Bird will take back the handoff. Looks at her options. Drazi tries to work the screen. Well, you can see where she was going with a pass, but enough pressure from the Chinese defense to actually force the turnover. Shoot the pass inside. Left hand hook is no good. That'll be a foul on the glass as Wilson takes a tumble.
That's
a good sign though. Chinese guys going hard to the glass.
That's a great move, great move. And you want to make these shots against a team like US is because you won't get too many opportunities to get
pressure.
And we see this first lineup of the US team is well more organized and second line
we've
seen.
Wilson almost lose it, does lose it. And the attempt to stop it with the foot is picked up, so 24 for China on the turnover. Seven-point game, China have the basketball. Zai Jing goes down low with a pass. Inside, outside, the three has gone, and he's dropped from deep. Wang Zhumeng with the three. Tuck on the floor, gets also the ball at the high post, goes with a runner for two, and again, that little lead to give space from the defense.
And she recognized, because Liu Yeru is already on two personal fouls, you need to attack her, because she's not going to play too aggressive.
Sue Bird has it. High low, nice change of angle. Brown Stewart can't get the two, though. And Xu Jing just comes up with it. Li Yuan. Meng. Go high, look high low, no option. Six on the clock. Meng goes through, gets the drop. They're going to count it.
Yep, and one. Is not happy with this call.
Yeah, the Charles is on the far side of the play. I'm not really sure how she has an opinion on this. She's saying it wasn't in the act of shooting. I have a lot of sympathy with her, but she was on the weak side to the drill, and the call was called for a reach from behind. It's only a one-shot foul because the two was good. Referees are got themselves sorted. Just to make it a three-point game halfway through the second quarter. Bird will advance the basketball, gives it up.
Almost like that the previous defensive possession for US. Diana was trying to get the attention of officials, and now he's going to reward it for.
Trazi looks inside, they look high low. Inside out, they finally get it tucked. Takes the three, it's good.
Yeah, it's great when the big player recognizes kind of like overplaying, but the defense is just able to keep the ball.
Oh, oh. Nice pass, got to make the little two. And Wang Zhumeng just blew it. Bird goes down low. Charles to the inside, a little one-footer, doesn't get the drop, but gets her own rebound. Needs to go out before they can come back in. Bird backs it out. Tries to space the floor. Attacks it on the right. Off the one step, doesn't get the drop. And China, a chance to run again. Extra pass to the corner, wide open. Back-to-back threes for Wang Zhumeng.
That's just really good running that breaks and reading is controlling the rhythm of their game as well. They don't rush their offense. They do run a quick break. No position, just let's do a quick passing game.
Rose is going to travel.
I don't know, Mark. It seems like US team is a bit out of rhythm. Just second quarter, and they already on the 9 turnovers again.
Puts the foot down.
Yep.
Foot down before she released the pass. Here's the replay of the last three. The extra pass, feet set all day and all night. China with a chance to tie it or come within one. Can't get it away. Meng into the keyway, blows the layup. And China will get a 14-second reset. They just missed two wide open looks at the ring.
They're using the space really well. Just moving. One player steps forward, someone else is replacing the positions. And definitely not static at all, and it's causing the problem to US defense.
It's going to be critical of the United States at the moment. This is about half the intensity they showed defensively yesterday.
Yeah, absolutely indeed.
Oh, they take the step through. job on the glass by Charles. They look long, ball stolen. Great defensive transition as Shai Jing gets a piece of that one in transition. Li Meng stepping through, gets the two this time. That long second step makes it a one-point game.
Yeah, Li Meng is definitely playing with the courage.
Again, moves it on. Clarendon gets it to Tarazi, drops the three. Numbers at the normal level of Deon Tarazi's in the second game of the World Cup. 2:40 to go in one, four-point game. Meng, he's been very effective, goes inside, that's a foul.
Yep.
It's a pretty good. Charles lets her get position and just leans on her and extends. Yes, she's right, Charles is right. Holds the forearm, but she can't push. Look at this, that's not a sharp forearm, it's just extended, so the official makes the call.
But again, previous action to this was the weak side screen. That seems to be really effective for Chinese offense.
She checks back in. Strong move, but defensive effort by Tuck was just more than enough to take away the drive lane. Tarazi has it in transition. Clarendon looks down low, they go lob. Wilson with the big catch and the good finish.
And the help game really, really late.
Throwing into the space behind the posted up plan, sealed off. Great take, 6-point game.
Oh. And another.
That's the third layup. China has missed without any challenge around the ring. Would have been a tight game just by making those. Then looks to turn the corner again, gets to the middle. Second step, leans, will draw contact and go to the free throw line. It's that second step, she just gathers and then goes past with the second step. She's made it two or three times really effectively. Wilson picks up the personal. And then go back to the free throw line.
That's such aggressive penetration, but it's not one of the quickest ones. It's more like she's using her steps around the defense really, really good. And I don't know, we usually say like if a player is going to be penetrating like this, it's like a fourth penetration in this quarter in the last couple of minutes actually. You usually want to really on the loudest player to get into that space, so you either have to stop her before she starts to dribble the ball or just push her away from that space.
Two for two from the line. Chinese fans are all enjoying this. Subdued atmosphere in the gym at the moment. 4-point game. 1:35 in the half remaining. Tarazi has it. Looks Wilson just ducks in. Looks to take the turnaround jump shot. Mm. She's foul.
From China, her second personal foul.
Done all the hard work for Wilson to take the tough jump shot over the top of her, a little off balance.
And the first was good.
She takes the first from the line. Sen checks in and will inbound the ball. She's come to replace Wong Saijin. Yuan gets China into the half court. Great defense. Tarazi just came over the top, gets the deflection. Wilson reaction on the weak side. Clarendon pushes, little floater off the glass for two. That's tough to stop.
Especially if you have Nico go make a screening,
you know,
that screen and there's no help.
45-37. China has got to hang on here. And again, the slow lob is going to result in the turnover.
It can work, but to be honest, to come on the offensive half and straight away try to throw that pass after the previous possession, US team already ready, so let's create something more of that weak side movement.
So Wilson will walk the floor to shoot the throws. Over 50 seconds to go in this first half. And it's getting away from China in this last 2 minutes. So Wilson makes the first.
Yeah, she's been 100% so far in the line. 13 points so far in this game.
It's become a 10-point game in a hurry. The last minute and a half, US just opened it up to 47-37. Three men will move it on to the corner. Oh. Jai Singh, inside Chao right. Ting for two.
Great big side cut again.
The team needs you. Chao Ting is never found wanting. Responsibility came to get the basketball in the last 30 seconds of the half. They're going to call Chao Ting for the reach. And as they're in the penalty, the United States will go to the free throw line. And as you can see, that's exactly what Coach Zhu Lianmin is pointing out to Chao Ting. Tarazi misses the first. China will want to hold for the last shot of the half. 22 seconds remaining. Tarazi makes the second, substitution coming in for China. Tarazi sits. Lloyd steps in for her. And Zhu checks in.
One possession should be for China. 22 seconds.
Step out, want to go inside. Deflected by Wilson. Nice matchup, the Wilson. Han Zhu matchup. Hope going at it strong. Griner. Hope the news is good all round for the United States and if she becomes a factor as this competition develops. 5 seconds, the three is away and he's way off. Clarendon at the halfway line is going to have to put it up. Almost makes the runner. And at the end of one. United States have opened it out to a 9-point lead late in the second quarter. 48-39. There's the confirmation. Great half of basketball. Statistically, the United States are 59-50, and it's going to take some. Staying with 43 for both two and three for China. Rebound numbers, as you'd expect, for the United States. 10 turnovers again, and if there's an Achilles heel, maybe turnovers is the thing other teams in this competition will really take note of. But that's the first half of the action over with here. We're going to take a break. We'll see you in around 10 minutes for the second half. And see whether the United States can complete the job and get their second win of this year's World Cup. We'll see you in about 10 minutes. Thank you. say, you've got to give some credit to China here because they've offensively really functioned well. A lot of penetration, moving away from the ball has been good. They've had issues in transition, they've had issues with Tina Charles' size on the inside of the Amateurs. You want to get a very, very good half basket to get 30 points. United States with a 58-39 lead. And if you're just a basketball fan out there, you're looking at this China team thinking, you know, in a 2 or 3 years' time when their young kids have got more physical presence on the inside, they can keep Li Yuang moving in the right direction. We're literally, you know, 8-9 players of this group, 24 and under. I think the future looks really good for China. Really good for Chinese basketball. You know, the right people are obviously making decisions about how that program is, how the program is developing. It's clear that Yao Ming is getting back, he's back involved in the actual future structure of the game. With his experience in the NBA, that's going to help China make some huge steps. And this is a real good test for him against the best team in the world. And they're really holding, they're doing a great job. I think it's great to see that both Senegal and China have come out and played hard against the United States, and forcing the United States to look like the best team in the world.
Yeah, indeed, and the United States stated before the game, before this tournament, it's going to be a hard tournament for them, and as you already mentioned, China is in the transition, and they've done an excellent job, because those two young bigs they have, Li Jie, Zhang Chu, they played an excellent game today, and they're not even showing the fear of most of the young players we have against the legend like U.S. team has, so it's very impressive performance so far, and we am pleased to see that China does control their rhythm of their game, no matter how or how U.S. team is not physical as they're supposed to be in this game. I'm a little bit missing the intensity from U.S. team because they need to be aware of that people around the world are watching this group. And you would love to see the perfect basketball from this team. Yeah, they are human beings, but it doesn't cost much to put a little bit more heart into it, a little bit more physicality, a little bit more intensity. So let's hope that they're going to come out of the locker room a little bit more determined to bring this heart into this game.
Okay, start of the second half, China trail 39-48. Just wait for 15 minutes to tick up, and we're ready. Start of three. China in the white uniform will get the first possession. Li Yuan has it. Stagger screen away. Pick and roll to the side. They get open. The defense steps under. The three's there. They can't knock it down. Defensive rebound is in, and Bird has it. Charles with a handoff. Double screen for Taurasi. He slips. And you see that so often on the floor vinyls. It's very frustrating for players.
And that's what we're talking about. They just enjoy playing this game.
And you. Oh, and she gets back. And that tells you so much about the 2-meter-5 18-year-old. She went the full length to get back and get a piece of that. Yuan. Attacks it, needs a pass, drops the bounce pass to Xiao Ting, ball reversal, the open three is long. Own rebound though.
Oh wow. There's no
great
defense.
Start.
There's no defense from US team, and I really am waiting for the moment that US is gonna start to put the heart into their defense. Oh,
straight down the middle for Taurasi.
That's the best response though, but now US needs to come back and just set themselves up in that defense.
Quite a disappointing thing, Trees, that was straight down the middle of the Chinese defense. So you'd have thought after the good start offensively that it try to make it work for it. Lai Meng in the traffic, finds the open. Yuan can't get the three to drop. Taurasi has it. Ngamakui is down the floor. She's going to get a look. Taurasi doesn't like what she sees. Kiana Stewart with the two off the pretty little pass from Taurasi. And the coaches are more unhappy. Zhu Li Min says, hey, that's enough. That's two layups. I'm taking the timeout here. We're good offensively, but hey, this isn't a scrimmage. This isn't an all-star game. This is the World Cup.
Yeah,
China take the timeout.
And you're right, absolutely. Basketball is played on both ends, not just in offense. And you don't want to give these open looks and easy layups to the US team. But credit to Diana, she's again delivering after that yesterday 7 assists. Because the attention obviously is on her, she's able to open her teammates as well, so she doesn't get too frustrated if she's going to miss a shot. She delivers for someone else, and that's what makes her an excellent player, that she makes the players around her that's the same as she's able to perform on her own.
I like the balance now of the Chinese offense, the more inside outside offense. It's really been a 3-point team.
And Xiao Ting and Li Meng are quite effective from the guard position. They do penetrate really well, but they're also able to shoot. The great balance is just set from Li Meng Zhu, coach of the Chinese team.
Well, Xiao Ting flashed to the middle, beats the press. Xiao Ting in the lane, takes the tough two, doesn't get the drop. Wonderkid comes down with a defensive rebound, looks long, great decision. Tarazi handles, nice pass. Charles going up strong in traffic for two.
Yep, and that was experiences. Dina Charles didn't rush that layup, just waited for Kang Chu to stay in the air and then shoot.
Nice move from two in the lane is good. Sun Meng Lan, who's having a great game at the moment. Drops it in Stewart. Goes off the glass for two. Once she's got set that close, she's going to make it. China into the half court. Trial 11. That's that little face-up from Pivot gives and Zhu enough space with that length to knock down the two. McQuay takes the tough two, is short, almost like she was looking for the chance to score. She hasn't had a lot of touches at the offensive end. Li Yuan will hand it off. Xiao Ting thinks she sees the drive lane taken away. Yuan will reverse the basketball. Li Meng steps back for three, has it blocked by Stewart. And just turn away, but they get it back. Fortunately, get it back. When we were speaking earlier, you know, during the half, that's one of those turnovers that's not generated by the defense at all, it's just generated by the US being a bit too loose with it.
Indeed, and that's a 12th turnover of the US team, which is such a high number, and I'm pretty sure they won't be happy by the end of the game. The way they do turn the ball over.
China into the half court. Wang Siyu checks in to the far side of the ring for two. Is good for Yang Liwei. Hanging around. That'll be a foul as Wang Yuming was late as she tried to go over the top. The fact she's trying to chase Tarazi. The intent is right, they're trying to take away the option. But
you have to chase down Anna Tarazi, otherwise she's going to punish that arrow defensively. She would just pull up the three-point line on the screen.
A little help from a teammate. You know, a teammate can show and take away the straight girl. Get through. There's Tarazi outside.
That's why I said you need to play a team defense against players like Diana Taurasi.
Stewart goes with the left hand off the glass for two. Soft hands, great finish. Well, three off one pass is just knocked out for fun. Wang Zhu Meng.
Old player, no fair.
On this team, she's almost a veteran.
You're absolutely right. You just said old players, most of the players are under 24.
Yeah, nine players, 24 and under.
Yeah, and you have to ask, like, are they playing with that young perilous against the US team, or are they really that good and that talented group? They are. They definitely have a bright future ahead.
There's the foul. And Ruby Roo, it's a hands out, stays in stance. She may well not get called for that foul. She's got to stay in stance.
Yeah, that's her fourth personal foul again.
It's like we said, in situations like that, she stays in stance, she'll make one less foul just by staying in stance. The referee will see her in stance, contact on her torso. Another key, tries to spin, step through off the glass for two. One key, such a tough player to stop. Well, they skip it to the open two, which is, I guess, a very friendly roll here in Tenerife.
You must really love the movement on the court from Chinese offense. Just spread out of floor, reverse the ball, finding open player.
You've got to credit the defense, the organization. Wang Siyu didn't rotate, which didn't have to, stayed in the lane. In fact, probably disappointed she didn't pick the pass off. There's the long two, just toes the line, and there's the friendly one.
And they just isolated themselves as the two players playing pick and roll on the strong side. The rest of the players were gone, so there's no way that US could help on that ball.
Stewart with catch and release. Just strokes and sweeps, all in rhythm. Knocks down the three, opens it out to a 9-point game. Again, Anzu has it. He goes in the middle, comes back to the turnaround, doesn't get the drop, but really on balance, chance to run. Clarendon has it, gives it up. Oh, Lloyd will back it out. We will reverse the basketball. Monkey looks inside. Wilson faces, takes the jump shot. Over 2 meters, five, and just knocks it down.
I just love this matchup of Asia Wilson and Sang Su. It's just so fun to watch them two battling themselves in this game.
Tries in, needs a pass, finds a pass. Wang Siyu is fouled as she ripped through.
Not really sure why Clarendon stayed on Chinese player, because they're quick in penetration, and especially Wang Siu, she's not the best shooter, let's say. She's going to look for that penetration. As soon as she receives the ball, you need to a little bit step back.
Great recovery. Gumma Quig was just so quick on the recovery. Stewart coast to coast for two off the glass. And Stewart coming alive in the third quarter, 13 points personal. United States leading by 13. Hughes outside, we'll move it on. Rising. Think about the three, Wilson left the floor, that cardinal sin. They can't make the two though. Hughes fights with it, gets it, they get a new 14. Tsai Jing for three, it's good. Clarendon pushes straight off the Timo Stewart, just beautiful finish. Timing of the pass was excellent. Scored against it, run the other way. Tsai Jing outside the three, puts it on the floor, down the lane, tries to wrap it, nice pass for two.
That's been great read from Kyung Sing. Open teammate Kansu right under the rim.
Now Stewart breaks to the foul line, takes the tough one, is fouled. And Anzu just bailed her out a little bit. Even indecisive, Anzu made it easy for her by fouling her.
This is a great recognition that Asia Wilson has dropped down for the help, and there was no third rotation in the US defense to cover. So Jewel Lloyd not being effective enough to drop deep enough to help for the shot.
By the way, Roberts will check out. That allows Lyman to check in. Stewart is good for the free throw line, as you expect. Offering the open look, it's like challenging you to make it, and that occasion Lei Meng could not get the three to go. Early three is no good for Morgan Tuck. Run the floor and outwork the opponent that time. Green gets the two, back to a 10-point game. The only way you can describe it is China refused to, you know, lay down here. Stewart puts it on the floor, gets in the lane, little floater is no good, gets her own rebound, goes back up. Can't complete, China get the stop. Oh, wide open.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow.
Well, someone's going to play, he's going to have to play some defense here. Otherwise, we're going to be racking up a score. 71 to 63. Lloyd finds Stewart on the three-point line. Chao Ting guards her. Stewart stops and pops off the dribble.
She's just showing why she has been MVP of the WNBA season.
Exploded in this third quarter, Brianna Stewart. Great rip through. Far side of the ring for the two is good. And the defense was absent without leave.
To be honest, Mark, I think we are seeing really struggles in terms of the weak side defense. They all so focused on the ball.
Wilson in the lane gets the two. Good ball movement. Thanks to passer. And you can see why Kozu Limin is agitated by this, because his team offensively, where you thought they may have struggled against the physicality of this United States team, is doing a really nice job, but defensively, it's hard enough as it is without giving them open looks from 2 feet. Going to hold for the last shot. 10 seconds of his third goal. They give him another layup.
And
Khaled.
And again, you would guess that someone's going to be under the rim on the split line. This is just like, I really don't see any weak side defense from the US team in this game.
Geez, I got to say, that Khaled is going to guard a player. He's just going to get blown past here.
That's absolutely right. The first responsibility of the player is to play one-on-one defense. That's absolutely correct.
Yeah, you've got to, players will get broken down, that's fine, but this is one of those like end of clock situations, end of quarter situations. You're going to put it on the floor.
Yeah, and then, you know, especially Wang Xiu, she's not the shooter. She's going to penetrate.
Lloyd attacks it, trying to get the two, and does.
Yep.
You know exactly what Coach Zhu Limin is going to be saying. Why haven't given up a layup at the end of the quarter?
68,
we've reached the end of three. And China have stayed with this. They trail by 9, 77 to 68 at the end of the third quarter. United States in the lead, possibly in control. China doing a great job. Like an offensive like clinic for both teams. Both teams shoot the ball really well. So where's the defense, Teresa?
That's a question. Usually defense wins the game. And defense is about how much you want. And it's not, I'm not saying that US team doesn't want, but you would expect from the lineup they have that they're going to break the defense on. And seriously, I'm a little bit struggling to find the big side defense from US team. China's using it really well as well, because they are fully aware of it, and they know, and they always look on that big side of the court. use the cut towards the ball. It's just so effective for China right now, and I'm really pleased to see that they play so fearless. They just stick to their game and try to create offensively against that no weak side defense.
29-29 in that quarter.
Yeah.
It's a hell of a scoreline for a quarter in this competition. Both teams really functioning at the offensive end of the floor, but both teams getting wide open layups. Now we would expect the US in transition perhaps, and there's not a number of transition baskets. Breanna Stewart had an unbelievable third quarter, but she was making like the three, she made a tough one off the dribble. China's just getting to the basket. Now it's not the number that the US has scored that is the question here, it's the number that allowed China to go the other way. Clarendon still in the game at the point. Gets it into the half court. Christian Wilson. Clarendon comes back off the down screen. Lines it up, thinks about it, puts it on the floor. Takes the tough runner off the glass, gets the drop. It's a tough move.
Yeah, Bantu couldn't do any more defensively to cover this penetration. She was in the right position. It's just Clarendon dead forward, isn't it?
We were outside the three-point line. Chai Jing. Oh, really a turnover by your own player. Zhai Xing with a three, he's good. And maybe a hand in the face would help. Zhai Xing's having a nice game from the three-point line, 2 for 2. Stop and pop for two is off. Great rebound, ball's loose. China have it, just about. Now they've got numbers down the floor, 4 on 2. And great hands by Clarendon. She literally saved an open look, gives it up, easy two, and you've got to give Clarendon so much positive about the way she just gets quick, gets her hands on it, and then chases it down, gives the easy two. What could have been an interesting little start to the fourth quarter, close to 6, is back out to 10. Name is as it's stripped, chance to run the other way, Tuck has it. He goes down low, ball's knocked away, chance to run. China in transition. Pass. Oh, she's just about recovered a balance to make the two. Xiao Ting run easy on her feet halfway through that layup, but did a good job to recover. Tuck puts it on the floor, going right, spins in the lane, in traffic, gets the drop and one. But I think that issues as a foul may have cost her the last action in the game. There's the fifth. And she wasn't really even involved in that. She just managed to get a foul.
Yeah, that's gonna, she's gonna feel sorry for that because you want to spend the time on the court against a team like US. You don't want to sit it on the bench. Yeah, you're right.
She was just late. Maybe she should have stayed out of the play.
And defense is bent. She was on the straight feet.
Steps out. Xiao Ting's gonna leave. No, she's not. Table wasn't quick enough on the buzzer for the Chinese coach. Pass entry on the horns, they skip it. Xiao Ting has it, puts it on the floor. Lloyd tries to guard it, but nice pass to the inside. And Kelsey Plum will push in transition. Mitchell Wilson steps back, takes that step away. Two is good.
Yeah, great separation from the defender. He's a shot for Asia Wilson.
3-1. Beijing with a tough jump shot. It's going to get her own rebound though. Puts it back up, gets blocked, and Wilson gets back in the play. Does a great job getting back in the play. Kelsey Plum gives it up. This is one of those times where the US getting a lot of momentum. Charles can't get it to drop. Foul called on the play. Why are we all walking? Looks like the ball's on Xiao Ting. She's going to step out. So is Lai Meng.
Her second
and some McLaren check in too. So four changes in one possession for China. To relieve the pressure, Lloyd rips through, nice pass.
Funny the thing, that was a chance to his help as a leash one. Got to drop down.
It's a tough call on hands you, as her expression tells you. Charles makes the Charles has looked what she is, which is just
she's
quality.
Consistent, yeah, she's very consistent with her performance.
It's quality though, everything she does on the basketball court. Gets a little hand, while cooking the net. Charles goes 2-2 for the right.
Pressure right now from Kelsey Plum.
Now to a 15-point game, which is the biggest margin so far. Job on the glass by Meng Lam. It's another 14 for China. Meng Lam wants it in the post. They go high. He just hands it off. Penetration, but Wilson has been superb at protecting the ring. I don't think that was actually meant for Megan Tuck. I think it was a cross-court pass, but she thought it was her. Gets a piece of it, knocks it out of bounds. Another turnover for the United States. Another look at Wilson staying in place.
Massive block. Not in my house. Okay.
Main Glam outside the three-point line. Moved on, almost stolen by Plum. Inside, outside, and they're going to turn it over.
That was a tough pass, to be honest. Passing a, like, over your back, kind of in the same line. Very, very tough pass.
Well, Brown Stewart comes back. Maybe there's a one of the questions, obviously, people are going to ask after this game, mate, does Della Don't have a slight injury issue? She's played very little minutes after her performance yesterday. Not seeing the floor in this second half with second half at all, 5:45 to go. Charles makes the long two. And it's the relentless nature of the United States here. Opening out a 17-point lead. China going to hang in here now for the next couple of minutes, otherwise this could get out of hand. Yang Leiwu in the lane, little runner for Wu Yuang. Work on the glass by Han Zhu. Morgan Tuck attacks it on the baseline, looks for options, gets blocked. Han Zhu both ends of the floor. Wang Zhumeng will take the early screen. Inside touch, turnaround jump shot is good.
That's her game today for China. And you must be very pleased to see. She's only 18 years old, and she's performing like she does in today's game.
Plum doesn't get the roll. Wonder what's going on in Coach Staden's mind. Come on. Offensively, they look better than they looked yesterday, clicking into gear. We said it was going to take first few games, obviously not a lot of time together.
Yeah, and also we see better intensity from US team than in the first half. Still the biggest concern is the defensive end, the strong lineup of the US team.
The UN will advance the basketball. Meng Lam finds the corner. Penetration to the far side, almost created the angle, couldn't get the finish. Wang Yuzumeng in transition, Tuck gets Stewart in rhythm as the second trowel is just... it's just so good to watch. In rhythm, gets a feet set, timing perfectly, strokes it. Meng Lam steps back for three, gets it to go. from Menglam. Charles will find Tuck for three, doesn't get the drop. Chance to run for Wang Yiwei and just throws it straight at Megan Tuck. Plum is fouled as she tried to break the defense down. That'll send her to the free throw line.
We also see China on the team fouls already. So every other foul is going to be rewarded by two free throws for US team.
Well, I think that's exactly what coach is saying to Li Yuan. Why did you foul then? Mid-court, yep. You're in the penalty. It's Kelsey Plum, she's not going to miss the free throw. Makes the first 16-point margin that is very likely to become 17, which it does. 4 points for Kelsey Plum, all from the free throw line. Well, the step back tough three is just way off. Never looked like it was going to find its way into the scorebook, into the stat book as a missed three, yep, but not into the scorebook. Substitution. Li Meng will check in. As Yang Lei steps down. It's a little learning point from coach.
Yep, and we see back Li Meng, who's really, really effective from that core position and the penetration.
Over 3.5 to go. The USA have a 97 to 80 advantage. Charles in the post will take the jump shot, doesn't get the roll. And China will hit Yuang. Menglam, second trial, will hit the second side. Meng inside for two, and she's been so effective, especially if she's received it second or third side, and on the shift of the defense is always a drive lane. She's got there again, this time instead of the two, she goes to the free throw line. She just breaks the defense down to the middle, and everybody's late. Everyone wants to block it. It's going to be a foul.
It's almost like it seems that it's so easy to block it, but she's just protecting the ball so effectively with that body, and she goes into the contact in the last moment of her move, and that's why she draws like loads of fouls on her.
Sun Meng Graham misses the first though.
See the Chinese bench and coach right now, Li Meng Xu. They probably will be happy with today's performance, especially for the three quarters of this game.
Ah, she makes the second. 2:53 to go in the fourth. 16-point margin for the United States of America. Lloyd puts it on the floor, tries to find an angle, finds the pass to Plum for three, is off. And Megan Tuck comes down with the offensive rebound. I won't put a body on it. The lane opens right up. Doesn't get the drop. And China have a chance to get into the 16-point lead.
Beautiful.
Nice
beautiful
pass. And Zhu has 20. Stewart puts it on the floor, drops it down to China Charles inside out. Plum lines up the three, is long. And China come down with another defensive rebound. And Yuang is fouled as she broke the defense down.
Foul ball number five, Kelsey Plum of the USA. Her first personal foul.
To the inside, is blocked. Going back up again, stays with it. It's not a way to get a full team, but again, they go. Great decision to the far side of the ring with a reverse layup. Sun gets the two, goes to 13. Lloyd inside, outside on the penetration. and the USA go five out at the moment. Tina Charles, long two, is short. And that is how to get an offensive rebound position. Stewart just boxed her out at the offensive end. And from that point on, Sun Mengram was not part of the game. Brianna Stewart, not a lot she can't do on a basketball court. On the free throw line. This is the free throw. I think it's called a commentator's curse. Yes.
Exactly. Once you say that, it's going to happen.
Absolutely right.
Something opposite.
Sue Bird liked it. Anyway, she's obviously got a feed from us. Goes one for two. 13-point lead. The US edge close to the 100 points. Yuan gets it back, lines up, the three is long. Stewart's everywhere, gets the defensive rebound, chance to run. And again, I don't think Li Yuan listened to coach Zhu Liming when he said, we're in the penalty, don't foul unless it's a bad situation. She had players back in transition. She fouls, and Kelsey Plum to the free throw line, hasn't missed from the line. This is almost certainly another two. Makes the first. This will bring up the 100 points. Normally gets a reaction from the crowd. Yang Laiwei checks back in. Li Yuan sits. Last minute. I think Sun Mengram sits as well. And Zhu just about hang on. Li Meng with a three is long. Stewart just hauls in another rebound.
Like you see Brianna Stewart in every position, man.
She's like a ball magnet. Yep. Every time offensively, defensively, she's involved. Now she looks to post. Plum looks at her, can't get an angle.
That's the Plum's laughing. She knows she almost killed one of the reporters on the baseline.
Yep. And Zhu sits, gets a huge reception from both sets of fans. This team enjoy each other. Big reception from everybody in the gym. She's just had a great game. Last 26, 25 seconds of the game. Feng Zhu Meng moves it on. The three is gone. It's down.
Sun Mengram, 75% from the three-point line in this game.
16 points personal. Plum in the United States of America. Are they going to walk this off? Yes, they are. And that has done both teams a lot of positive things as this tournament really gets into its stride. United States of America and China have played out day two, and the USA get the 100-88 win over a Chinese team that is building a base here to keep making strides in the world game. There's one of the major reasons why. Han Zhu, 20 points. The United States go to 2-0, guarantee that they will top the group. And China getting a reception from the whole gym here. Both sets of fans. This Chinese team has enhanced this reputation enormously. And two, star now, she has a future. That's a tremendous performance by China. I mean, the scoreline 188 with these stats, 51% from the two. Both teams offensively very effective. Rebound wise, China tried to hang in there, but
some little missed bunnies really hurt them earlier in the game. 24 and 22 assists. Fun game to watch. The purists in the gym, like me and you, might be talking about how much defense was or wasn't played. But let's take the positive out of this. That was a super offensive game by both teams. And as I say, I think both teams will get a lot of positives out of that going forward in this tournament.
I can only agree, and it will be interesting game when China's gonna play and face Senegal after tomorrow's break, because I believe China really has got better. When you're playing top teams, they're gonna challenge you, they're gonna make you better game, better basketball. But I could see a huge improvement compared to that yesterday's games against Latvia. China's team has been stronger on the board as well. They didn't give up like so many offensive boards. They definitely fought through this game, and they can come out to the changing rooms great from today's performance, from missing performance, let's say, to the quarter stages of this tournament.
Pleasing thing for China has got to be on the inside how many options were created, either on penetration through the dribble or penetration on the pass. Not just Han Zhu had a really super game. Example of that with that turnaround jump shot. But they had penetration to the hoop, which opened up the actual kick to the three. And they actually played a really balanced offensive game. Now, physicality-wise, obviously, they have got to find a way to just get a little stronger defensively. Yuru cannot get into foul trouble the way she has. She can improve her. She's only 19 years old. She can improve her physicality in terms of quickness and actually just pure strength. This team has a lot of positive things to look forward to. You've just played one of the most talented teams that the USA has put into a world championship, and you've lost by 12. We can talk about the finer points. That's a great performance by China, and I think it's a really good performance by the United States in terms of building as they prepare for the second half of this competition.
Yeah, I can only agree, and back to Chinese team, you can see, and it was fun to watch them, how much they know about each other on the court. You almost feel like they don't really pay attention to certain players, and suddenly the player's gonna receive a ball or receive a screen on the weak side. It was really fun to watch this young team of China. And as you said, US team, they're building up. They have experiences within their roster. I was very pleased to see Brianna Stewart step up that second half, and she just proved why she was MVP in WNBA.
Well, there's the group table, USA at the top. China and Senegal will play off tomorrow to decide who's second. But for now, from Tenerife, hope you've enjoyed that one. We have. We'll see you soon.
李梦，实际上这场比赛我们在之前可能没有想到是这个结果，在奥运会上我们输了对手43分，那今天这场比赛是不是应该给我们自己的队伍点个赞？首先我觉得我们今天做的是相当可以了，就是已经是打出我们训练的水平了，而且就是也是算是超常发挥吧，因为我们就是今年。